turn on my stereo and jump up and down. It's scooter time, it's scooter time, it's scooter time, it's scooter time. What are you doing sitting on the couch? You need to get up and jump right now, cause it's scooter time, it's scooter time, it's scooter time, it's scooter time.
Kid, hey kid.
Did you hear something?
Hey kid, yeah, kid, you were in the boat, down here.
Who's talking to me?
Kid, yeah, you. Over here on the floor.
Oh, hey! Who are you?
The name is Dusty. Dusty the Dustball. What's your name, kid?
Well, my name is Scooter, and this is my room.
Not for long, kid. Not for long.
What do you mean?
Germs, dirt, grim. They're all moving into this place because nobody cleans this room.
Wait a second, I clean my own room.
Sure you do, kid. When was the last time you cleaned under this bed?
Well, I don't know.
Come on, kid. How you think a dust ball can get as big as me?
You got a point there, Dusty.
Just what do you do when you're told to go clean your room?
Well, I get started with lots of energy, but then I quickly get bored. I mean, who cares if it's messy? I mean, it's my room. This is my place. Besides, my friends think it's cool.
That's fine, kiddo. Like I said, soon my friends, Germs, Dirt, and Grim will be in control here.
No. No way, you mean old Dusty Dustball. This is my room. It's time for Lady Clean Bean.
Oh, hello. I am Lady Clean Bean. I am the greatest room cleaner in the world. And Scooter has no problems whatsoever. I will have this room cleaned in a jiffy. First, I will grab all the dirty clothes.
Wow, I better hide on this bed or that Lady Clean Bean will sweep me up in a minute.
We're going to pick up the dirty clothes. My apron is falling off. I've got all the dirty clothes up and I put them in the hamper. Now it's time to tackle the trash. You know, kids, besides having a clean room, it is also important to have a clean us. Yes, the first line of defense for us when fighting germs is washing your hands. Here's our very own guru of clean, Dr. Winter, with a musical message just for you.
Oh yeah, I'll tell you something I think you'll understand. For the sake of sanitation, you better wash your hands. You better wash your hands. You better wash your hands before and after meals, and when you use the can, soap and water for 20 seconds should be part of your plan. That's how you wash your hands. That's how you wash your hands. And when you're finished, you'll feel happy inside, washing so thorough that microbes, they can't hide. They can't hide. They can't hide. Make sure you wash your nails and dry with towel or fan. Prevent those nasty microbes from spreading across the land. You better wash your hands. You better wash your hands. And when you're finished, you'll feel happy inside. Washing so thorough that microbes, they can't hide, they can't hide, they can't hide. Oh yeah, I'll tell you something, I think you'll understand. For the sake of sanitation, you'd better wash your hands. You better wash your hands. You better wash your hands. Why don't you wash your hands?
Dearest Scooter, I've cleaned your room from top to bottom. I moved Dusty the Dustball and all his friends into the trash and out of your life. From now on, however, cleaning your room is your responsibility. Remember, Scooter, it's okay to make cleaning your room fun. No one is watching, so you can clean and be crazy. Oh, just stay motivated. I know you can do it. Sincerely, Lady Clean Bean.
Wow. That Lady Clean Bean sure can clean a room. Oh, hey, what's this note over here?
Dear Scooter, now that your room is clean, it is up to you to keep it that way. Your friend, Lady Clean Bean.
Don't worry, Lady Clean Bean. I'll keep my room clean. I don't ever want to see that dusty dust ball again.
Scooter, who are you talking to, huh?
Hey, Abby. I was just reading a letter from Lady Clean Bean.
Did she have to come over and clean your room?
Yeah, but don't worry. It'll be the first and the last time. From now on, cleaning my room is my responsibility.
Good for you, Scooter. Good. Yeah, that's great. Looks good, too. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
thanks. Good. What are you doing outside?
I'm doing my homework. Yeah, I'm out here doing my homework. Mm-hmm.
What are you working on?
My teacher wants us to learn about the weather by going out and exploring the weather.
So what have you learned so far?
Well, I've learned that the weather is very talkative. Yes, it is. Very talkative.
Talkative? What do you mean talkative?
Just take a moment to think about it, Scooter. There's the wind, the rain, there's hail, and there's sleet. Each time one of those things come our way, the weather is talking about us. You know, they're talking to us.
Hmm. So what does the wind say?
Ooh, ooh,
all right, all right. What does the hail say?
Clatter, 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 clatter.
Then what does the rain say? And what does the sleet say?
Slush, 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 slush.
Wow, Abby, the weather really is talkative.
Those kind of weather sounds were easy, but what kind of sound does the sun make on a perfectly beautiful, wonderful weather day?
Yeah, what does the sun say on a perfect weather day? Hey, I know. We should ask the science lady.
Oh, wow, Scooter. That's a great idea.
Yeah, yeah. Let me just grab my magic remote control. Hi, science lady. Tell us about the sun.
Yeah. Thanks, Scooter. I'm Miss Ricky, the science lady, and today we're going to talk about the sun. At night, you can see lots of stars and the moon because the sky is dark. When the sky is bright, you can also see a star, and that is the sun. The sun is the closest star to us on the Earth. The sun is very big. If the Earth was the size of a marble, then the sun would be the size of this beach ball. You can see that it's very big. It's also very far away. It would take more than 3 years for a spaceship to reach the sun. The Earth is like a big spinning ball. It spins around once in 24 hours. The sun shines on only half of the Earth at a time. So as the Earth is spinning around, the sun shows day in half of the Earth and night on half of the Earth because it's in the Earth's shadow. We can show that with a flashlight and a globe. The part of the Earth that the flashlight or the sun is shining on is daytime. As the Earth spins around, the day becomes night and the night becomes day. Think about what you like to do during the daytime and what you like to do at night. You can do that by taking a paper plate and draw a line right down the middle. Then I wrote the word day over here and the word night over here, and I drew pictures of what I like to do during the day when the sun is out. I like to eat breakfast. I take the bus to school. I like to play outside, and I like to go to school. Over on this side is nighttime. I drew a moon and stars. I like to watch TV. I like to read. I like to take a bath, and then I go to bed. So you can see the different things that you do in the day and the night. That's because the sun is shining on half of the Earth, giving us day, and the other side is in the Earth's shadow, giving us night. Back to you, Scooter.
That science lady is the best.
She sure is. I learned a lot, Scooter.
Did it help you with your homework?
Yes, it sure did. Thanks, Scooter. But I still have a reading assignment, so I better be getting home, okay?
Okay. Yeah, I still need to write about my field trip in my journal.
Did I hear thunder? Thunder?
You better get going, Abby. I think an alphabet storm is on its way.
See you, Scooter.
Wow. Abby got out of here just in time. This is one big alphabet storm moving in. Oh, here it comes. Here it comes. It looks like the letter S was the reason for this storm. Are you okay? Super! I like the letter S because squirrel starts with that letter. Squirrels are generally clever and persistent animals. In neighborhoods like yours, they are notorious for eating out of bird feeders, digging in planting pots, and flower beds to pull out bulbs, which they chew on or bury. Did you know that birds, especially crows, will watch a squirrel bury a nut and dig it up as soon as the squirrel leaves? Squirrels are expert climbers, and primarily in trees. Despite many complaints about the animal as a pest, most like squirrels, thanks to its cute appearance, intelligence, and its eating styles and habits. Squirrel. It starts with the letter S.
Oh, haha. Welcome, see, to the No Sleeves Magic Minute of Magic. I am El Mago, and today I'm going to show you how to do magic with everyday objects, because magic is all around us. I need my assistant.
Hello, my name Rokus Rokus.
Rokus, you do not need to tell me your name. You are my assistant, I know your name.
Oh yes, sorry. Hello children, my name Rokus Rokus, and today I have brought along the daily magical challenge for El Mago. El Mago?
Yes.
I am afraid today's challenge is going to be very difficult.
Why?
Well, because today, the only objects you have to make a magic with are a salt shaker, a quarter, and a paper towel.
All right, I will show you how to make magic with a salt shaker, a money quarter, and a paper towel.
I would like to see.
Watch. I'm gonna make the quarter disappear. I put the quarter on the table, I put the salt shaker on top, and I put the napkin on top of that. Now watch, on the count of three, I'm gonna make the quarter disappear. There's the quarter.
All right.
One, two, three.
Oh. You did not achieve magic.
I know this, I will try it again. Watch the quarter, on the count of three. Oh, Rokus. I forgot I'm supposed to make the salt shaker disappear. See? Let me get the salt shaker. I'm sorry, children. Rokus, he always faints. Now, I will show you how to do this magical secret. All you need is a quarter. You can do this at lunch or dinner. You take the quarter. You say you're going to make the quarter disappear. You take the salt shaker. You put it on top, and you take the napkin or the paper towel, you put it on top, but you'll notice that if I lift up the paper towel, it keeps the shape of the salt shaker. This is gonna be a key element in making it disappear. Now, I tell everyone I'm going to make the quarter disappear, but this is not true. It is called misdirection. I'm gonna make them look at this place because when they look here, I will secretly drop the salt shaker into my lap. Now watch, I say I'm gonna make the salt shaker disappear. I put the napkin down just for a second, you know, and I say, whoopsie, the salt shaker's supposed to disappear. I smack it like that down and it disappears. I reach under the table, like towards the center, and I grab the salt shaker and I bring it back. Well, that is your No Sleeves Magic Magical Minute. I am El Mago, and if you see Rokus running around on the streets, do not never tell him my magic secrets.
Brush my teeth, yes I do. I need to brush my teeth, and so do you. So let's go down the list of what to do, and I'm gonna brush my teeth with you. Now hold up your toothbrush.
Hold up your toothbrush.
Get out the toothpaste.
Get out the toothpaste.
Now put it on your toothbrush.
Put it on your toothbrush.
And brush,
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 brush.
Here we go. That was some good brushing. But there's a lot more teeth left in there. Let's do it one more time. I need to brush my teeth. Yes, I do. I need to brush my teeth, and so do you. So let's go down the list of what to do, and I'll brush my teeth again with you. So hold up your toothbrush.
Hold up your toothbrush.
Get out the toothpaste.
Get out the toothpaste.
Now put it on your toothbrush.
Put it on your toothbrush.
And brush,
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 brush.
Here we go. Now look at that smile. Yeah.
Shh, shh. Listen, quiet, quiet. I think I hear something. Do you hear that? Yeah, it sounds like knocking coming from inside the story box. Should I open it up? Okay.
Well, it's about time you open up, Scooter. Do you know how long I've been knocking?
No.
Never mind that. You're all saying 1 minute. Give me 1 minute.
Really, me?
Yes, just listen to the crowd. Now hurry, get on down to the story box on the double.
All right. What's up, Mr. Story Yeller? Woo! I am a grasshopper. And I bet you know what grasshoppers love to do. What do you think? That's right, jump up and down. Woo! In fact, grasshoppers can jump 20 times their own body length. That's a lot of jumping. If you'd like to jump, join me and let's go. Boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. Come on! Boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. I like to jump up and down, and when I jump, man, I hear the sound. Boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. You can jump just like me. Get up and jump. Come on, jump with me. And boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. Let's jump like grasshoppers do. Let's jump all over the room. And boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. Let's jump over there. Let's jump everywhere. And boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. Come on. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, boing, boing. Come on. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, boing, boing. I like to jump to and fro, and when I jump, oh, I jump off the floor. Boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. I like to jump over here. When I jump, everybody cheers. Boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. Let's jump up off the floor and then jump. Jump even more. Boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. Let's jump and never stop. Let's jump and hop, hop, hop. Boing, boing, boing. Everybody go boing, boing, boing. Come on. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, boing, boing. Come on. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, boing, boing. Boing, boing, boing. Woo! Keep on jumping like grasshoppers, yeah! Boing, boing, boing. I can't believe our time is up. Wow, it really zips by. Remember our lesson about washing our hands and keeping our room clean. You don't want germs, dirt, and grime to take over your room. Join me again next time for another great edition of Scooter Time. I'm Scooter. Peace out. Ah!